In this video, we look at the action timeline effects for compositing in the sequence. You have already learnt that you can use the 2D transform timeline effects for basic compositing. However, the action timeline effects brings 3D compositing, tracking, keying, and much more to the sequence. As a reminder, the sequence can have as many video tracks as you want, and each video track can be considered as a layer for compositing. So to composite this layer over its background, select the segment and press the Control tab for the effects ribbon. Select the action timeline effects. Now, if you've used the 2D transform timeline effects, you need to enable the comp timeline effects to composite the layers together. However, since action is also a compositor, you don't need to turn on the comp timeline effects. Just ensure you enable use back in the action's basic parameters bar. So instead of a black background, action will composite over the underlying layers. Now, like all other timeline effects, the basics parameters bar will give you quick access to tools like position, rotation, and scale. There are even more tools available through the tools pull-down menu. But to get right into the action compositor, click the editor button. The first thing I'm going to do is go to the bottom right of the screen. Change the selection mode to all and reset all the settings done with the basic parameters bar. Now, there is a ton of creative functionality in Action. But to keep it simple in this video, we'll only concentrate on image surfaces and lights. Before we do that, let's set up the Action layout to help clarify a few things. Click the Layout pull-down menu. Change the option from a single view to a two-up view. This is mapped to the Option 2 keyboard shortcut. Select the left view and press Escape. This switches to the action schematic. The action schematic shows all the objects in the current 3D composite. Select the right view and press F4 to see the action result. If you get a white frame, you are looking at the action alpha output. So just press F4 again to get to the result view. This layout will help you manage the composite's objects as well as seeing your composite result. A big point to know is that everything is selection sensitive. Select an object before you make any adjustments. Now, when you apply the action timeline effects to a segment, you start off with an image surface, a light, and a camera. In the action schematic, the light is just one node. The camera is also one node, but it's off screen at the moment. However, the compositing image is made up of two parts. You have the image node that allows the image to exist in 3D space. The axis node controls the positioning and other transformations of the image in 3D space. You will notice they are connected together. If you break this connection, you will not be able to move your image in 3D space. If you do, it's not a problem. Just drag a connection between the nodes. Make sure the connection arrow points to the image because the axis node is driving the image node. Each of these nodes have their own controls. For example, double-clicking on the axis node brings up the object menu. Since there is a connection between the axis and image nodes, the object menu will display the controls for both objects. On the left are the axis transformation controls, and on the right are the image surface controls. So to move the surface in the composite, you have two options. You can either drag the transformation slider values for accurate pixel positioning, or you can ensure the cursor is set to select mode in the tools menu. Select is mapped to the Shift-M keyboard shortcut. You can see in the viewer that there are some on-screen widgets. Just click and drag on the widgets to move the surface in the view. The image surface controls give you access to the properties of the surface. For example, you have access to a pull-down menu with various blend modes, so you can set how the surface blends with its background. I will remind you that Action is a 3D compositor. So 3D objects, like the surface, float in 3D space in front of a virtual camera. The relevance of that point is that your image is actually being textured onto a flat 3D surface object. and this surface object is moved in a 3D environment. So Smoke blends the world of 2D imagery and 3D compositing in various ways. For example, you can change the type of surface that your image is texturing. The default surface type is flat for a simple flat 3D surface. The next surface type is bilinear. This 4-point surface is designed for corner pinning and 4-point tracking. If you've used corner pinning tools in other applications, this will be familiar. The third surface mode is extended bicubic. This surface can be physically bent in 3D space. This will add true depth to your image, even if it was completely flat to start with. If you switch to the vertices menu for the extended bicubic surface, you can divide your image into further sections. This allows you to manipulate the inner parts of the surface in any way you choose. I've seen this used to create warping effects, fixing camera distortions, and even aligning two locked-off cameras. But if you don't need the subdivisions, you can always merge the sections together. In the future, we will cover more advanced tutorials on these surface modes. For now, switch back to the surface menu and set the surface type to flat. Now let's have a look at the light. Double-click on the light node in the action schematic. In the action timeline effects, you start off with a single light. To use the light, turn on the shading button. Shading refers to how objects react to lights. This light can be moved around the viewer, and it will only light the objects in the scene. The background will remain unaffected. You can use this light to create highlight passes. And you can dial down the spread to create a focused spotlight. There are loads more controls to play with, and you can have as many lights in the scene as you want. Here are a few more points on action. To the right of the interface are the viewer navigation, animation, and reset controls. To the left of the interface are the viewing options, animation, and setup controls for action. Our final point to remember is that the action timeline effects is being applied to a segment in the sequence. So the current source is the only source you can use for layers in the timeline effects. When you use action in ConnectFX, you will be able to load any source as media for action. Please move on to the next video to continue your Smoke Getting Started experience.